गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ संदीप पाके, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन कॉमर्स। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक रेसिडेंशियल स्टेटस। इन दिस वीडियो वी शैल वर्क आउट प्रॉब्लम ऑन रेसिडेंशियल स्टेटस ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल। प्लीज सी प्रॉब्लम नंबर 3। मिस्टर मार्क हेनरी केम टू इंडिया फ्रॉम यूएसए for the first time on 30th September 2013 to join an American concern as production manager. Write down solution. First column write down arrival, second column write down departure. He came to India, write down in arrival column 30th September 2013. This date will comes in 2013-14. Next, after reporting for duty, he went to Germany on 5th October 2013 to finalize the firm's transaction. He went to Germany, departure, 5th October 2013. This date will comes in 2013-14. So write down departure column 5th October 2013, right in bracket 2013-14. Next one. He returned to India on 14th October 2013. He returned to India, arrival column write down 14th October 2013. This date will comes in 2013-14. Next, stayed in India till 3rd July 2018 when he went back to the USA. He went to USA on 3rd July 2018. 3rd July 2018. This date will comes in 2018-19. So write it in departure column separately, separate again entry maadi 3rd July 2018. Kya varshadalli baruthe 2018-19. Next, he came back to join for duty on 2nd November 2019. Once again, he came to India on 2nd November 2019. Write it in arrival column 2nd November 2019. This date will appear in 2019-20. Completed. Next, find out his residential status for the previous year 19-20. Okay. Next. First of all, write down previous year 2019-20. Next, write down assessment year 2020-21. Next, write down stay in India during previous year. Previous year 19-20 list dina irthane find out maadi 19-20 data nodi. Okay, he came to India on 2nd November 2019. Okay. He stayed in India till 31st March 2020, okay, 2019-20 ಕೊನೆಯ ವರೆಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ 2nd November 2019 ಟು 31st March 2020, ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಇಯರ್ 1920 ಎಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ 31st March 2020, ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ಎಸ್. ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೇಸ್. ನವಂಬರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 30 ಡೇಸ್. 2nd November to 30th November, number of days stayed in the November 29 plus December 31 plus January 31 plus February 29 leap year plus March 31, total 151 days. Completed. Next, find out his residential status, whether he is resident or non-resident.
to become resident, he has to stay in India for 182 days during the previous year, or second condition, second basic condition, 60 days during the previous year and 365 days during 4 years preceding the previous year. Okay, whether he fulfills first basic condition 182 days, no, he does not fulfill first basic condition. Next, find out whether he fulfills second basic condition mentioned under section 6(1) of the act, that is 60 days during the previous year and 365 days during 4 years preceding the previous year. Okay, he stayed more than 60 days during the previous year, half of the basic condition B fulfilled. Next, find out whether he stayed 365 days during 4 years or preceding the previous year. Exception to the basic condition B not applicable to him because Mr. Mark Henry is not an Indian citizen. Okay, he belongs to USA. Okay, next, write down year preceding the previous year. Okay, 2018-19, 2017-18, 2016-17, 2015-16. Completed? Yes. 2018-19. Please see the table. Okay. He went to foreign on 3rd July 2018. 2018-19ralli ondu data kottidare, Bharatinda bittu hogtane nodkolli bere deshakke. Andre he stayed in India till 3rd July 2018. Okay, to the 18-19, which begins from 1st April to 3rd July 2018. 1st April 2018 to 3rd July 2018. Completed. Number of days stayed. April consists of 30 plus May 31, June 30 plus July. Okay, up to 3rd July. Okay, up plus 3. Number of days stayed, 94 days. Completed. Next. 2017-18, he came to India in the year 2013-14 and went to outside 2018-19. Okay, andre adara madhyadalli aata bharatalle irtane. Okay, 2017-18, okay, full year indiyalle irtane, 365 days. Okay, 16-17 same 365 days, 15-16 same 366 days. Okay, yes, find out number of days stayed during 4 years. If you analyze 4 years data, you can come to the conclusion that he stayed in India for more than 1190 days. 94 plus 365 plus 365 plus 366, number of days stayed during 4 years preceding the previous year, 1190 days. So he becomes resident. Next, find out whether he is ordinary resident or not ordinarily resident. In order to become ordinary resident, he has to fulfill both the additional conditions mentioned under section 6(6) of the act, namely he has been resident for 2 years out of 10 years preceding the previous year, and he has to stay in India for 730 days during 7 years preceding the previous year. Okay. Yes, find out 2 years resident out of 10 years. 18-19. Okay, foreign citizen. Okay, he stayed in India for 94 days. First basic condition fulfill madala, second basic condition fulfill madtane, 60 days during the previous year 18-19 and 365 days during 4 years preceding the previous year. Okay, adar hindina 4 varshadalli ottariyagi 365 dine irtane. Okay, so he becomes resident. 18-19, residential status, resident. Next, 17-18, 365 days, more than 182 days, so he becomes resident. 16-17, 365 days, he becomes resident. 15, 16, 366 days, more than 182 days, so he becomes resident. First additional condition fulfilled. Next, please check whether he fulfills the second additional condition, 730 days during 7 years. If you analyze 4 years data, you can come to the conclusion that he stayed in India for 1190 days, more than 730 days. So he becomes ordinarily resident of India. Ordinarily resident of India. He fulfills both the additional conditions mentioned under section 66 of the Act. So he becomes ordinarily resident of India. Okay. Write down conclusion. Name of the assessee, Mark Henry. Assessment year 2021. Previous year 1920. Residential status, ordinary resident of India. Okay, next, write down explanation. Mark Henry stayed in India for 151 days in the relevant previous year and also did stay in India for 1190 days in 4 previous years preceding the relevant previous year, and so he has fulfilled second conditions of section 6(1), hence he becomes resident of India for the previous year 1920. Mark Henry shall be treated as ordinary resident of India as he was resident of India for more than 2 years out of 10 previous years and also did stay in India for more than 730 days in 7 years preceding the previous year. These are some information relating to problem number 3. Thank you.